When we talk about data being open, we mean accessible in the long term for others to find, to scrutinize, and to reuse.
Publishing an open access paper is not the end all on the road to open science. There are many more components there. Open data, open methods and protocols, code availability and data statements are all part of the goal of having a truly open science.
Open access and open data go hand in hand in advancing and accelerating discovery and innovation. For example, in the field of rare diseases, there may be very few cases for a given condition around the world. And so to build evidence to identify causality for that disease can be incredibly difficult without open data practices.
Some of the biggest challenges facing humanity can only be solved on a truly global scale. And for that, we need data and the results of research to be accessible and usable at a global scale as well.
Certain data may be too sensitive to be shared openly, for example, to protect participant privacy. So we also talk about data being as open as possible and as closed or restricted as necessary. In addition to open data, we also talk about data being fair, meaning findable, accessible, interoperable, and reusable. In order to support the integrity and reproducibility of research, underlying data needs to be made available for reuse and interrogation by the wider research community.
Data we think of very broadly, and it can be spreadsheets, it can be videos, it can be photographs, and it can be whole genome sequences.
Where data are not accessible, this leads to expensive and unnecessary duplication of research. And the cost of inaccessible data has been put at up to 26 billion euros a year in Europe alone. It's also worth remembering that research data are an important research output in their own right. The research article contains the analysis and the interpretation of the study, but the research data are what the researcher has created fundamentally.
At Springer Nature, we aim to support authors to share their data as much as possible. One way we do this is through publishing data articles, and we have several journals that do this, for example, Scientific Data or BMC Genomic Data.
Governments, funders, and universities are increasingly aware of the fact that sharing data openly measurably increases the impact of the research they support. In November 2021, the 193 member states of UNESCO unanimously voted to adopt the UNESCO recommendations on open science, which sets out a framework for stakeholders at all levels to develop policies that encourage greater openness and transparency in research. In the US, for instance, the National Institutes of Health recently declared that from 2023, the data collected in all the research that they fund should be made accessible as soon as possible after publication or at the end of an award. Springer Nature is committed to helping out authors satisfy the aspirations of their institutions and funders by making open sharing easier and by helping everyone to increase the impact of their research.
At Springer Nature, we work in partnership with the open research community to help researchers get the most out of their data. We are integrating data repositories with our systems, for example, Figshare, to make it easier for authors to deposit their data and for readers to access data once it's published. We also want to improve how articles and data are linked, and our partnership with OpenAIRI uses AI techniques to help uncover these links, categorize them, and feed them back into the research ecosystem. Researchers have told us that they have concerns around data misuse, and there is increasingly an acknowledgement that data sharing is about quality and not just quantity. Springer Nature has a history of supporting data integrity through specialist checks and data peer review. We are working to embed more of these checks throughout our journal workflows and specialist roles.